In the last video, Raman spectroscopy was used as an innovative tool in plant science. But this technology can also help us, humans, by diagnosing diseases, for example, cancer.
Nowadays, breast cancer is one of the major causes of death in women, and early detection and therapy are always the most important factors in fight with cancer. Modern X-ray technology can already detect small tumors below 1 mm, but the reaction of the immune system to the cancer occurs even earlier. Recently, scientists found that breast cancer can be diagnosed from the change of proteins in tears. You already know from my previous videos that Raman scattering is inherently weak, but surface-enhanced Raman scattering is a very popular tool to enhance these weak Raman signals. Nanometals, mainly silver and gold nanoparticles, exhibit the localized surface plasmon resonance effect under laser excitation, which increases the Raman signal of substances in close proximity. There are about 1,500 proteins and other substances in a single tear. Naturally, a tear's Raman spectrum contains the sum of all Raman responses of all ingredients. It is therefore impossible to determine protein changes directly from the Raman peaks. For their publication, the researchers collected tear samples from healthy volunteers and patients. By using principal component analysis, PCA, the difference of the spectra was quantified, and each Raman spectrum was given a score. With the scores, the spectra were clustered into two groups and a reference model created. Now, this model can be used to check unknown samples and predict if a sample is from a patient with breast cancer. First trials were reported to have 96% accuracy. Furthermore, the measurement of a tear sample only takes 20 seconds. Hard to believe, isn't it? Lately, applications of Raman spectroscopy have been emerging with increasing frequency in the medical field. As a fun fact, and according to the latest report, the upcoming Apple Watch will have a built-in Raman sensor for monitoring blood sugar.
With this impressive application, we reach the end of our series. I had lots of fun explaining the basics and must-knows of Raman spectroscopy to you. I sincerely hope that you found joy in my explanations and maybe even found some new ideas of how to use a Raman microscope. You're welcome to contact us for an exchange of ideas. Goodbye and see you in next series.